What's going on, boys? Sekapoko here, bringing another One Piece Treasure Cruise video, and today we're going to be going over One Piece Treasure Cruise news. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a longer video because there is a lot to go over, and there's lots of cool stuff that's coming out in the next couple days in One Piece Treasure Cruise, as well as the next week or so on One Piece Treasure Cruise. So definitely make sure to check it out, the whole video, make sure you get everything in there that you want to see, and we're going to go over as much stuff as we can. Before we start the video, go ahead and make sure you hit the like button down below, as well as the subscribe button down below, so we can support the channel and make sure it keeps growing. As well as, if you do want to get more notifications on Sekapoko videos, go ahead and go to my channel page and make sure you hit the bell notification to get notified on every Sekapoko video. All right, without further ado, let's get into the video. So, for this video, we're going to be going over the Sukofest, the rate updates, exactly what you're going to get on each day. We're going to go over some of the new things that are happening with the new stuff that just came out, as well as what's going to be happening over the next week or so, and the new Fortnite that is dropping on One Piece Treasure Cruise. And I think that's... and we're also going to go over a little bit more on the rate-up units as One Piece Treasure Cruise, as well as what this whole thing is here. Now, we're going to start it off with this little thing here. Now, this thing is just like an info blur telling you exactly what this is right here. And as you can see on the screen, these are basically just items that you're going to get every day at reset o'clock or on login. I'm not really sure. I'm pretty sure that reset o'clock you get them instead of the daily reset time. And what they're going to be is they're just going to give 200,000 experience. That's it. They're just turtles. That's all you get. They're just turtles. And each of them just fits in your box space as one box spot. You can see I have one right here. I have the new law version thing. And if I feed it to a character, it will just give 200,000 XP. There's nothing special about it besides the XP. So if you do get this thing, don't freak out. It's just XP. That's all it is. Okay, here we go. You just click it. You can see it just costs 1,500 berries and it gives you 200,000 XP. Nothing special about it. You just get the XP. So don't worry about that. If you get, it's just basically them giving us half of a princess turtle every day. So that's kind of cool. I mean, you can collect them and you can just Pokemon out on them if you really want to. So that's also kind of cool if you wanted to do that. So next up, we're going to be going over the adventure mode and exactly what's going on in the adventure mode. So the adventure mode has finally been released, and we know that starting on the 13th, the adventure mode is going to have a bunch of cool things. Let's see, Sukofest. There we go. Has a bunch of new things with boosted rate points. Now, we had a list earlier, and it was actually just the limit break list. It was not actually the boosted unit list, and it was kind of like mistranslated, says misinterpreted of what it was. But we finally get the whole list of all the units, and if you just click the adventure mode, you can actually go in and see what everything is. So the highlights, of course, Akainu is a 1.5 boost, Squard is a 1.3 boost. We have Judge being a 1.2 boost, acting kind of like Lucy did last time the adventure mode came out, and his whole batch being boosted at 1.1. Now, also the new King Dolji, Riku, is going to be worth 1.1, as well as the Fortnite. Rebecca's mom, I don't know her name. As well as the new Fortnite Caribou and Korobu are going to be on there, and the new Invasion Garp. We have the new Raid Caesar, Colosseum Sicilian. If you go down further, we can see we're also going to get, where are we at? Legend Hody Jones, Legend Lucci, Legend 6 plus Sengoku. So not, which is really weird. You can only use 6 plus Sengoku as a boosted unit, but you can't use 6 star Sengoku. So if you don't have the Inskull, you legit do not get points. That makes me a little salty. Not gonna lie, that makes me just a little salty. There's also in Sicilian, this is the Colosseum Sicilian, of course. We have all the Kai raids, so this whole block is Kai raids. Then we have Raid Monster Chopper, Raid Fuji, which is out tonight on One Piece Treasure Cruise Japan. And of course, finally, we're gonna have the Adventure Mode Mihawk as the final units that's boosted. So we have a good pool of units that is boosted. It's going to be a little tricky on getting everything done, but it should be completely doable. Now, there's going to be a Magellan stage, a Croc stage, and a Whitebeard stage, just showing us that we're actually not going to have anything that was pertaining to the Mihawk. There's going to be a Magellan stage with 4 mini-bosses, a Croc stage with 4 mini-bosses, and a Whitebeard stage with 4 mini-bosses, which is, you know, not terrible. Now, the Croc stage has Mr. One... what's her name? The spiky lady. Doublefinger. Bonclay and... I can't remember his name. The Int dude with the sword, this Bonclay and Mr. Three. Mr. Three, I think that's his name. Magellan's gonna have Hannibal, which is gonna be a dex unit. It's gonna have the Int pull down lady. I don't remember her name. The other Sadie, and then it's gonna have some green Impel Down dude that I don't even remember his name either. They're probably gonna blow through it. And you're not gonna worry about it at all. Now Whitebeard is gonna have Cy Marco, Dex Ace, Strength Josu, and Quick Vista as the mini bosses leading up to him. So it's gonna be one of every type, and then finally we're gonna have Int Whitebeard. Now Whitebeard being Int and what's his name? Judge being Psy. Obviously, it was meant to counter that. So, you were meant to use Judge for that fight, which means it's going to have a lot of the counter abilities in the Judge team for that, as well as the what the new Strength of Kainu does and the new Dex Squad. So, those will fit on your team perfectly. So, that is going to do it for the Adventure Mode. All right, next we're going to be moving on to the Suga Fest, which is happening tonight, which is probably one of the more hype things that people want to know about, exactly what the rated update is and what you should be pulling on and all the information there. So, of course, we already went over the information on the Suga Fest, but to reiterate, the Suga Fest is going to have a guaranteed legend on the 3rd, 5th, 7th, and 9th pull. On the 11th poster is going to be a guaranteed legend, and the first multi is all gold, and every other pull is going to be gold and silver, or red. Now, part one is going to they're going to alternate, so it's going to go one day one, part one, part two, part three, and then part one, part two, part three, then part one, part two, part three. So the 9-day Sugo, they are doing one part per day, and then they're going to alternate, so you have the chance to pull on each banner before the new adventure mode drops. So they're giving us a little bit of extra chance there so that everybody can have a chance of getting all the units that they want to before the adventure mode drops. Now, part one is going to have, for the legends rated up, it's going to have Lucy, version 2 Law, and Shirahoshi, all of which are boosted, all of which are very good units, definitely worth pulling for, is of course, and then last we're going to have Fujitora and Whitebeard rated up. Whatever. Then we're going to have the new Suga Fest of Kainu, as well as Squard going to be on there as well on every day of the batch. Then on the day one, we are going to have only one unit that is going to get a 1.1 times point boost, which is going to be Vinsmoke Ichiji. Every other unit on that banner is not boosted. So, GG day one. What the heck? It has the entire batch for the Lucy batch. It does have the entire Magellan batch. It has a lot of OG units that do have some limit breaks. So, I mean, pretty much this section is good. The rest of this is just old stuff. Day two is going to have version 2 Boa, Magellan, Nekomamushi, sorry, part 2, not day 2, which is also day 2, God Usopp, and Bartolomeo. Then we're going to have the Suga Fest rate-up units, of course, the Akainu and Squard, and then Niji. Now, it's going to have the entire Boa batch, which has Marguerite, Boa, Marigold, and Sandersona, yay. So all of those are really good. Day 2 also has Beppo, Mr. Zero, Fukuboshi, G5 Smoker, Speed Giro, Docu Mancherry, Virgil and Diamante, Ricky, 3-Day 2-Way Nami, Virgo, Captain Kid, Rouge, Tal Nami, Basil Hawkins. So pretty much once it says Virgil and Diamante, everything else is crap. Speed Giro is not even that good. It's okay. And G5 Smoker is only used on one fight ever. So that's interesting. So day two, also not so good. Day 3, however, does have more boosted units, and the Legends are actually boosted units, so it looks like Part 3 is the best day to pull for boosted units to make sure that you get units that do have that 1.1 times boost, because there's going to be the Vinsmoke Judge going to be boosted, it's going to have Rob Lucci version 1 boosted, and Hody Jones. It's also going to have version 2 Lucci and Sakazuki on that day, so you have the chance to pull two really good legends as well as some of the other boosted units. Now, the rare considered boosted, there is a total of 4 boosted units. Of course, we have that Kainan Squad, but you actually get Reiju and Yonji on that day. However, the day is completely crap after that. It gives you the old Fishman Bash without Fukuboshi or Ikaros, so that part really does stink. Ikaros is not even on this banner, which is kind of weird. And it gives you, what's really interesting is every single one of these characters here, I think, and besides Sidemarco, I don't know if Sidemarco got a limit break, but I think almost every single one of these characters just got a limit break. So day 3 is the limit break day. So if you wanted to use any of these units, or you wanted to limit break any of these units as well, that's the best day to pull for limit breaks and boosted units. I'm really not a fan of the Sugo. I checked out the rates. They're like 11% for a 5-star character. That's including golds on the first pull. And it is an 88% chance for a 4-star character. And the legend rates are not super, super great. So definitely not my favorite Sugofest. I probably am not going to be a fan of doing like a ton of multis. This is not like a Sugofest. If you're trying to get legend on the Sugofest, this is not for you. If you're trying to get a couple gold here and there, like point boosted units, this could be for you. Limit broken units trying to fill out your last couple golds. That would be this kind of Sugofest for you. Otherwise, I'd say hold off on pulls unless you really, 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 really really want to whale before New Year's comes here. I don't know why you would, but you could if you wanted to. Now, we're going to get into some more hype news in here in just a minute. Alright, so for the next bit of news here, we're going to be going over the news batch that just dropped and is actually really, 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 really cool. So, you can see here, we're going to actually have the first bit of news here. All Evolver and Booster Islands will be available from the 18th and the 19th, the 23rd, as well as the 25th through the 26th, and the 2nd through the 3rd. So, we're going to have a lot of days where we can actually have every Evolver Island and every Booster Island available, so that if you do need Evolvers or you need XP for Turtles or whatever, you can actually run those islands without having to worry about it, which is very, very, very cool. The second bit of news is the most hype part about this. I'm really excited about this. I am a little salty about this, but I'm also excited about it. So we're actually going to get the new Zunisha Adventure, along with the Zunisha Island can drop a plus 100 cotton candy, Princess Turtle, All Mighty Manos, and Forbidden Tomes. I think this is you unlock it, and you can only open it once for 30 Rainbow Gems. I'm going to say that again. The new Zunisha Adventure, along with Zunisha the Island, can drop a plus 100 cotton candy, Princess Turtle, Almighty Manuals, and Forbidden Tomes. You can only open it once, but it costs 30 Rainbow Gems to open. That's right, 30 Rainbow Gems. Wow, that's expensive. The next Fortnite announced, which is super, super expensive, so we're going to have to think about this. If you really want this new ship, the new ship is amazing. It is the new ship here is a, if you clear this eventual, you get a powerful Zunisha ship. The Zunisha ship is going to boost the attack of powerhouse and cerebral units by 1.55 and their HP by 1.25. It is also going to make perfects easier to hit, as well as making, this is the best part, making TND and meat orbs beneficial to powerhouse and cerebral units. Now, if you limit broke your Sanji like me, I'm salty now, because they just made meat orbs beneficial on powerhouse through a ship, and I just limit broke the Sanji that had that, so now I'm a little salty that they did that. So, whatever, just gotta roll with it. Apparently they decided to do that, and it was right after, so I'm kind of salty. But Bandai does some mean things sometimes. You can also get other precious rewards like the Cotton Candies, Princess Turtles, and Almighty Manos on this, as well as the plus 100 Cotton Candy thing. So that's cool. I don't know if I'm going to buy the ship for 30 gems. I'm still a little salty. We'll see. We will see. So we're also going to get a new Fortnite that's coming out, which is going to have a Rouge Hawkins, a Pooh, and X-Rake on there. I don't know why there's four units on a Fortnite, but apparently you could only get a Pooh and X-Rake. Maybe there's two different Fortnites? I think there's two different Fortnites. I think there's going to be one Fortnite that's... Yeah, it says right here. So it says there's one Fortnite that's X-Rake and Pooh, and then there might be another one after that. We haven't got any information on that. It didn't actually say, I don't think. But we do know the books that are available for that. We're going to have Nekomamushi books and some of the books from the Impel Down batch. So we are going to get either the remainder of the Impel Down batch books, and we're also going to get some other books thrown in there as well, which is kind of cool. So if you do want to skill up your Nekomamushi, definitely the best time to do so is during this Fortnite event. So that's very, very cool as well. Now, there's going to be zero stamina raids on certain dates, which I am super weirded about. They cost zero stamina. Like, these raids cost zero stamina? I'm really confused. So, I was trying to get some clarification on the zero stamina raids. So apparently, when Ansu was doing the translation for this, it says that you're going to be able to run this unlimited times until you lose. I don't know if that's right. I don't know if it's true. We're actually going to have to probably see it, how it comes. The translation might be a little bit off. It might be correct. I'm not sure because it's really weird. But it looks like we're going to have from the 21st to the 23rd, we're going to have Zephyr and Kuma. And then from... And also one more, I don't remember, I can't really read that, but that's, on the 28th through the 30th, we're going to have Virgo, Doflamingo, Aokiji, and Enel. I think that's a little mistranslated there. I think it's like, I think Zephyr through, Zephyr, Kuma, and Enel are on the first 3 days, and then Dofi, Virgo, Aokiji on the next 3 days. Doesn't really matter. But zero stamina raids, that's super hype if it's true, if you can run it unlimited times. That would be really, 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 really cool. Even though I farmed these recently and I got them on half stamina and like lots of other times, I would not be salty because I'm down to socket out a bunch of Kumas. I'm down to socket out a bunch of Doflamingos. I'm down to like finish socketing my Virgo. I'm down to like limit break another Zerg, like go into like a Dex, my Int Virgo, down to socket a bunch of different Aokijis. I'm totally down. This is fine. I'm cool with this. I like free stamina. Free stamina is nice. I don't know if you get XP, but that would be pretty cool either way. So if it's true, that's awesome. But if it's not true, I mean, the translator is to blame. Alright, the next we're going to have the Cotton Candy Sanji Islands coming back, finally. We haven't seen them in a while. Not that we really needed them, because we have so much Cotton Candy floating around right now, so it's not a big deal. We're also going to have the Cola coming back from that. I'm probably going to skip that, because I just get too much Cotton Candy. I'll skip that. We're also going to get the special Evolver and Booster Islands coming back, which is really, really cool. You get the free gem every single day from those, every time you complete them, and you get the free boosters and Evolvers, which is really nice if you really need them. So that's cool. We're also going to get half stamina on a lot of different stuff. So we're going to get half stamina on the Belly Cave, Turtle Islands, Evolver Islands, all that stuff is going to be half stamina. Really, really, really nice. And we're going to get half stamina on story mode for every single item, island. Every single story island is going to be on half stamina, so that is super, super good. From the 20th through the 26th, you have a full week to grind out any story mode missions you want to grind out on half stamina. Very, very nice if you haven't done so already. Now, we are also going to be getting half stamina on rookie Fortnites and returning Fortnites. So we're going to be getting a couple different Fortnites. We have, you can see the old Brook Fortnite. We're going to have the Kraken Fortnite. Boo, don't farm that. It's crap. Don't farm it. We're going to have the blue-haired dude. I can't remember that dude's name. Doc, whatever. He's actually semi-good. So, like, he's good for, like, one speed farm team that I saw, which is, like, because it does massive AoE and lowers your HP by a lot. So that's kind of cool. So you could use him for that if you really wanted to. And he's on a pretty short cooldown. I might farm him just for that reason, because I did want to use him a couple times to speed farm. Then we have the Sentomara Fortnite coming back. I might skip that. We'll see. Then we have one of the Ivankov Fortnites. It's the skinny Ivankov Fortnite that has, like... what's his name? The dude that Boris needed to pull forever but didn't pull. Senior Pink. It has the size Senior Pink books. And then it has the new Kid Fortnite, which has God Usopp books. And it has Kid Sockets and the new Fortnite Kid if you want to farm them as well. So I might farm that for some of the books that are on there on Half Stamina. I'm very grateful that it put on Half Stamina, so that's nice. And the Rookie Fortnite's in Half Stamina is also good for anybody who wants to farm that as well. So that's cool. I'm pretty happy about that. We are also going to get the Cola Island. I'm gonna skip that. Max Cola, I'm good. We're also going to get 2x skill up on the 18th through the 20th, and then on the 29th through the 1st. So in 9 days, we're going to have a skill up, and then just 9 days after that, we're going to have another skill up. After that skill ends, there's only 9 days between that and the next skill up. So that's actually really good. That's basically 3 skill ups this month. That's pretty fire. I'm so down for that. That's pretty good. We're also gonna get 2x super success for 3x in the next couple days. So we're at it right now still, I believe, and we're gonna have it to the 14th through the 16th and the 23rd through the 26th and then the 2nd through the 3rd. We're also going to get daily gems every single day, just like normal. So that is really, really cool. And all of that is super, super nice. So definitely very, very cool stuff. This right here is just going over some of the information that we're getting for this. So it's going to be fire. So for the last bit of news here, we have the new Fortnite that's going to be dropping on One Piece Treasure Cruise Japan with the Apu and X-Drake. You can see Apu and X-Drake are going to be dropping here, and we have a lot of Chopper Man missions along with them. So to go over the Chopper Man missions really quickly, we're going to get Evolve Apu, you get a gem. Evolve X-Drake, you get a gem, which is really nice. You get 2 free gems there. If you clear it if you clear it 20 times, you do get a lot of different stuff there, so that's really cool. And they are giving out free Nekomamushi books, free Log Cave boots, and free Impel Down Ivankov. So the books that we're dropping on this Fortnite are Nekomamushi, Impel Down Ivankov, Log Kid, Van Auger, Doc Q, my farmer just for the Doc Q, and the Impel Down Ivankov, and Story Icaros. Where the heck my Hody books at, bro? Jeez, I need my Story Hody books. We just got the Strength Hody and you skipped it? Come on, where are my Quick Hody books? Bandai is so mean, dude. They are stingy with those Quick Hody books. They are stingy. Oh, my Quick Hody books, man. Story Icaros comes first, but no, we can't get Story Hody. Giving me that. Story Hody is so good too. I really want his books. Cause he maxes at nine or ten turns. I can't remember which, but it's really good. All right, so the rewards finally are 1x for berries, 2x for an X-Drake, 3x for Psy Turtles, 4 for one Apu, 5 is going to be strength turtles. Then we're going to Evolver Mats for the X-Drake on the 6th clear, Evolver Mats for the Apu on the 7th clear. So they're giving you all the Evolver Mats that you need to evolve both of the units so you actually get to evolve them for free. That's great. 8 clears can give you a Princess Turtle and a Strength Princess, a Side Princess Turtle. Then a 9 is going to be another Princess Turtle. And finally, 10 times for a gem. The 11th is going to be 3 X-Drakes, then 3 Apus. Then you're going to be, after that, it is all skill books. It's going to be a Log Kid skill book, then Impel Down Ivankov skill book, then a Nekomamushi skill book, which is nice. Then on the 17th time is going to be Log Kid, Impel Down Ivankov, and Nekomamushi. And finally, on the 20th clear, they're giving you 2 of all of those I just mentioned, which is really nice. So they are giving you a total of 4 Neko books for free if you just clear it 20 times, making it a little bit easier for people that are clearing it for just the Neko books. So that is very nice of them. Well, guys, that is going to conclude the news video on One Piece Treasure Cruise, going over all the new news events and all the cool things that are happening on One Piece Treasure Cruise. I'm Sekapoko. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy the video. If you do enjoy the video, please hit the like and subscribe button down below. And of course, have a great rest of your day. Peace.